nevertheless, it is better if we incorporate the software program, the textbook, convert it into some lessons, and if we provide the CDs rather than providing the text, because they are just kept aside and they don't consider. So it will be a better way for the teachers and the students to think about that, and teachers have to be persuaded to use those CDs in the classes, right, and rather than doing the conventional textbooks, because no one prepares. The teachers go on reading and explaining those matters conventionally. This is happening to English language teaching in most of the classes.
Yes, absolutely.
So it is better if the ministry appoints some experts to prepare some online materials, or what we call as e-books or something like that. It will be very useful, I think.
Yeah, that's according to our experience, that the people who are working at the Ministry of Education do not have such knowledge. That's
yes.
because we have first-hand experience on that
one. Actually, right? I would like to add something, that because the current scenario with the Ministry of Education as well, that because from the National E-Learning Resource Center, we are closely working with the Ministry of Education as well. Now we are actually approaching to answer those questions from our side as well. As you said correctly, sir, because we have to use the blended learning method, as you said correctly, that because blended version is not enough today.
Yeah, yeah.
So they need to access materials anywhere from any time. So now we are trying to train our teachers as well as the students, especially teachers, based on how they can prepare that blended learning materials effectively and efficient way, as well as in an interactive way. So in that case, I think probably in near future, they will turn up that conventional teaching material into more digital interactive material as well. So in that case, we can improve bit and bit. So the need is there, yeah. So we are ready to provide that situation to answer all the questions. So we'll see in near future.
Yeah. I would like to share my experience. When I teach at private schools in Sri Lanka, I use some activities. All the activities are based on IT-based activities.
Okay.
Without using internet, you can't answer the question. All the activities must be prepared based on IT. IT or internet or something.
Yeah, that's what called interactive lessons,
yes.
Right? Because normally we have only teaching materials online, but there is no way to assess the students. So we have to have two-way communications from there as well.
And also certain assessments can be transferred
yes.
online.
Not just paper-based assessments, but transfer some of them to online as well.
I come from Central Europe, from Slovenia, and I can tell you from my experience and from experiences in the countries all around us, the main point in using ICT in education is to change the way of teaching and especially the way of learning.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have active learning, you don't need much ICT, and as you mentioned, you need, when you have active learning, then you recognize what is the value of the ICT, because students can investigate, they can support their cognitive processes, and so on and so on. And it's motivational, and they will find themselves a way how to use ICT. If you have just passive learning, just transmissive methods, then you can use ICT just for distributing learning materials, which is not much. But with active learning, you actually profit.
Yeah.
Yes, I think the main thing is the curriculum, basically. If we prepare the curriculum to skill-based chapters, it should be 60% practical or 40% theory, and which is just vice versa. So it will, force the teachers and the students as well to include more practical applications of the theory or the concepts which we are including in the curriculum. So starting from the curriculum, it will perhaps change the behavior of the teacher, how they train the students, and the students' learning method will also. So I think it will come from there.
Yeah.